everyone. Today we're going to look at a plugin for Blender called Avastar. Now, Avastar is the plugin that I use to create or to rig and animate my Lycan character, my werewolf here. If we go to their website at blog.machinimatrix.org and we go to their Avastar page, you can see tons of documentation on this program. It's well documented, anything you want to know. And it says here, animation and character creation. Yes, it does. You know, it's very good at animation and character creation, just like for my Lycan avatar. But it's also a great program or a great plugin to rig clothing. So if you're a clothing designer, this is the perfect program for you. Basically, Avastar takes the long, tedious, arduous process of rigging, weighting, and animating your avatar creations and makes it just super easy, ridiculously easy. Of course, whenever you're weighting a character or their clothing or whatever else, there's also a bit of play in there where you can have you can adjust things, and that's always going to be a pain in the butt. But once you get that process down, or once you've got the perfect weights for your character, then you can transfer them using Avastar super easy to any other piece of clothing or any other thing you might make. And I'm going to show the process real quick here for you. So I'm going to take a new scene and I'll get rid of the cube, of course, and we'll add in an Avastar character. Now, this Avastar character is essentially the Second Life default character. And it's has all the different bones that you need. It's all fully rigged and everything. And if you look at the side panel here, it has all the different settings that you might have or that you would have in Second Life. Like, I could make the avatar taller, shorter, change their body thickness. All the same settings that you would have in Second Life, even for, let's go to the torso. So we could change anything about this, make more muscular. So you can adjust the character in Avastar, in Blender, to fit whatever character you need in Second Life. So we have this default Avastar character, and I'm going to go to layer 2 and I'm going to import an object. And this is going to be a piece of clothing, some pants that I made real quick. And I'm going to show the Avastar character. And as you can see, I made the pants to fit the character perfectly. Now I have to weight these pants to the character, and of course they make it super easy. So I'm selected on the pants. I'm gonna hold shift and select the rig. Then I'm gonna go to parent to armature. I'm gonna select with weight copy, so that means it's going to copy the weights from the character, from the Avastar character, to my pants here. So I hit, see that again, parent to armature, and it should be fully weighted and everything. So let's select on the pants, let's go to weighting. Let's go to the rig and go to pose. And then select the pants again. There we go. There we go. Oh, and I have to click this. And as I select the joints, you can see all the weights are there on the pants. And if I move his leg, just like that, the pants are weighted. Now you might need to do some adjusting to the pants depending on how you want the pants to fit. But you're pretty much set and ready to go. If we go back into object mode, select the pants, then I can go right up to the Collada exporter for it exports it in Second Life's Collada format. And I can click this Collada format, put it in the folder that I want, and save the file. And then import it back into Second Life. So now let's take a look at my character that I'm working on now, the Lycan here. And I have different layers here that I have different objects set to. See, this is his hair. And the hair is all sectioned into different parts. And that all gets weighted using Avastar and everything with different types of clothing that I've made for him. And I can... Let's change this to element. So yeah, all of his clothes are all weighted and rigged to him and everything. And if right now I'm pretty much done with most of the character and weighting and all that stuff, so now I'm working on animation. So with Avastar, you have a pretty powerful import, BVH importer. And then if we go to and we use the animation layout, we have all the tools that we would need to animate this character really well. And then a really good exporter, if you look on the left here, I have to select the rig, a really good exporter to export the animation into a format that Second Life uses. So you can export in an M file or a BVH file. And either file will work inside Second Life. And now the default viewer, Second Life's default viewer, Linden Labs viewer, also has a BVH and an NM file importer. And with NM files, as you can see on this character, so let's go back into my the default view. As you can see on this character, I actually rigged the jaw to the skull bone so I could open and close his mouth. Now that skull bone is not a normal bone in the Second Life character, but if I export this file as an NM file, I can use that bone. So NM files allow you access to more bones than a regular BVH file would have. But that's basically a quick look at Avastar and what you can do in Avastar. So it's great for character creation, it's great for animation, it's great for clothing designers, mesh clothing designers. Basically anything centered around the character. And if you need more information or if you get the program, you can go to Gaia Clary's YouTube page where she has literally dozens and dozens of videos demonstrating how to use different aspects of Avastar and Blender to create things for Second Life. So have a good one, everyone, and have fun with the plugin.